Okay guys, ini adalah BRV yang facelifted. Kita akan bagi test drive. Going for the test drive in this facelifted BRV. It comes with modulo package. That's why the car looks so handsome. Dia datang dengan modulo package sebab tu dia nampak begitu cantik dan menarik sekali. So jangan ke mana-mana, ikuti kami. Jangan lupa like, share dan subscribe. Okay guys, let's take a look at the brochure for the BRV first. The new BRV comes with a very nice face. BRV yang baru datang dengan muka baru. Dia ada apa nama projector headlights, tapi dia masih halogen. Shark fin antenna, bumper yang baru, dual tone tail lights. Okay, engine dia CVT lah, 1.5 Dia yang the V spec has got pedal shifters. So the key is standard Honda 7 inch display. There's a tweeter, push start, your audio, multifunction lah steering. And then dari segi boot space, dia ada 539 liter, 539 liters in terms of boot space. The back seat is slightly smaller than the expander, the last third row. Baris ketiga dia lebih kecil daripada expander lah. Okay, dia datang dengan new interior leather seat. Okay, dia cakap more spacious. Tak begitu spacious lah banding expander. Expander menang. Okay, dia ada rear aircon ventilation. Ventilation lah. Kena ingat lah. Ventilation. And then dia ada VSA, ABS, new start assist, ISOFIX, reverse camera. Only the V-spec gets a reverse camera, guys. So modulo package, what do you have? If you buy a modulo package, you get this 1, 2, 3, 4 items. Modulo package is 5,000. 5,001. You buy the urban package, you get the door visor, side step, sports pedal, running board. How much is the urban package? 2630. 2,600. If you buy the utility package, is the cargo tray, trunk organizer, sunshade, car cover. Utility package is 1,082. Okay. Then the rest you have all this protection, blah blah blah. Okay, go check out yourself. That's about all. Saya nak bagi tahu engine engine BRV 4 cylinder 16 valve single lah, single overhead iVTEC. Displacement 1.5. Power 120 PS, 145 Newton meters of torque. Okay, dia punya gearbox CVT lah. Sebab tu ni, tapi dia lebih powerful lebih kuasa daripada expander. Okay, dari segi suspensi, depan MacPherson, belakang torsion beam sama dengan expander. Sistem suspension is the same. Belakang pun drum brake sama dengan expander. Tire size 16 inci. Saya dah lupa expander punya size apa-apa. Okey, dari segi berat, in terms of weight is only 1.25 tons. Okey. Ground clearance is 200, expander is probably 202 or 203. Same, lebih kurang sama. Okey. So dia ada 5 warna. There's 5 colors. Pearl white, purple pearl, lunar silver, modern steel and passion red. So the car that we test drove just now was Passion Red lah. So that's a BRV for you. Okay, we just take a look around of this car as we go for test drive shortly. Memang cantik dari luar, memang cantik eh. So kalau lawan dengan Expander, dari segi penampilan dia kalah sikit lah. Dia nampak macam MPV kan. Yang Expander nampak macam sporty sikit. Yang ni nampak ada tua sikit. Tapi dia ada cantik dia sendiri. Okay, ini terpulang pada sendirilah. This is up to you in terms of design. It's up to you whether you like this design or you prefer the Expander. So this looks okay. Not too bad for me. But the Expander looks younger lah, more trendy lah. Okay, but let's see the equipment and everything inside. See whether it's good. Okay, jom kita pergi test drive.
Okay guys, kita pergi test drive sekarang. BRV eh. Guys, we are testing the BRV. First impression eh. Kita dia kuat. Ada kuasa eh. Car is powerful. Raring to go. Don't really have to step on the accelerator. The car is already moving. So this is the facelifted one. How long has BRV been in the market?
I think 3 years, 3 years something.
Oh, supposed to go right?
Left,
left,
left
first.
Left.
Okay. 1.5.
1.5, yeah.
Okay, ini 1.5 eh. Okay, bila tekan minyak dia jalan eh, dia jalan. Okay, bunyi engine lebih kurang macam Expander, tapi Expander bising sikit. The engine sound of the Expander is louder than the BRV eh. But the BRV is easier to drive. Easier to drive because the power is
the left.
Greater eh. Dia lebih berkuasa daripada Expander. Sekarang 40 eh. 50, 60 kita ambil corner eh. Okay, handling dia dengan Expander lebih kurang lah, lebih kurang. The handling in terms of cornering is almost there, just like Expander. In fact, maybe this one has cleaner. It's a slightly cleaner, a bit more. Let's try another corner. Okay, undulating roads.
The T junction, we turn right.
Turn right, okay.
Yeah.
Dari segi comfort eh, comfort, keselesaan. Okay, bunyi angin masuk 70 eh. 70 we can hear the sound, the wind sound. Bunyi angin. Ada polis cari makan. 70 kita boleh dengar bunyi angin. Expander menang dari segi itu. Expander 80-90 pun okay. Straight lah. Turn right.
Kanan, yeah.
Okay, kita ambil corner eh, kanan. Okay, dia confirm eh, confirm. Bila kita ambil corner, dia lebih tajam daripada Expander. Okay, kita putar lori.
In the T junction, we turn right.
Turn right, okay. Okay, lepas 80 kita dah boleh dengar bunyi engine. Bunyi angin masuk 70 lebih lah. 70 lebih eh. So you can get the wind noise at about 70 plus. The engine is much quieter than the Expander. Okay, bunyi engine dia lebih senyap daripada Expander. Expander punya bunyi engine banyak bising. Okay, dia punya handbrake pun bagus. Expander punya handbrake macam senapang eh, besar. Dari segi dia punya glass nipis lah, nipis. Sebab tu dia kalah Expander. Okay, getah dia pun okay. The rubber is not too bad. Okay, let's take another corner. Confirm ada bunyi angin, tapi semua kereta sama lepas 100 semua confirm ada bunyi angin. Tapi ini dia masuk bunyi angin lebih kurang 70 lebih 80 lah.
Okay, itu sebab kadang tak ada door visor, ada bunyi sikit.
Okay.
Kalau depends tu tak ada door visor dia
okay,
boleh.
Okay, can you please show the door visor? Okay, please show the door visor. Okay, kadang-kadang dia ada door visor sebab tu dia ada bunyi angin eh. So sometimes there's a door visor. The door visor gives more wind sound. So therefore, if you take out the door visor, is it an accessory, optional one?
Yeah, option.
Okay,
lah.
Kalau anda tak masuk option door visor, mungkin dia akan senyap sikit lah, tak ada bunyi angin di kelajuan yang rendah. Okay, so you know. Otherwise, the car handling, kita tengok ada terapung ke tidak. Actually, it's not too bad. Okay, because the road here is quite nice, so it's not too bad. In terms of the floatiness, it's not really that floaty lah. Very, very good suspension tuning. Suspensi dia ditala dengan baik, tak banyak terapung-apung. Berbanding dengan expander semalam, expander lebih terapung sikit. Okay, the expander is a bit softer compared to PRV, a bit softer in terms of suspension tuning. But if you put in 7%, saya rasa kalau anda masuk 7 orang, kereta PRV senang dibawa berbanding expander, sebab expander engine dia dari segi kuasa dia kurang sikit. You know the specs,
Yeah, we 124 horsepower.
Okay.
So with CVT cable.
Okay. Top, how much is the top? Nah, testing you. Okay, dari segi horsepower dia 124. So this car has got 20 more horsepower than the expander.
Sorry, 120 horsepower.
This car has got 120 horsepower, so it has got
145.
It has got 15 horsepower more. Go right,
Okay. Go
then
straight.
Come back,
Not bad,
Not bad. Your test drive wrong is not bad. Okay, dari segi torque dia ada 140.
145.
So the torque is 145, almost the same as expander. Expander is 141. So generally the power for PRV is better than the expander. Okay, dari segi kuasa PRV menang. PRV ada 15 horsepower lebih daripada expander. Dari segi torque lebih kurang sama, dia ada 4 Newton meter torque lebih daripada expander. Expander 141, PRV 145. Okay. Okay, let's try high speed cornering. Okay, high speed cornering is very good, it's very stable. Sangat stabil, Sekarang 90 lebih, kita ambil corner. Sangat-sangat stabil.
Newton.
Okay, very very stable. Okay, ini jalan kasar, this is a rough road. Not too bad. Boleh tahan dia punya tayar di permukaan yang kasar, di jalan yang kasar. Okay, cornering dia lebih tajam, confirm. Cornering dia lebih tajam daripada expander. Dari segi kuasa, dari segi bunyi enjin, dia lebih bagus daripada expander, Dia lebih sporty lah. This car is more sporty than the expander. Let's confirm. And it's much much nicer to drive than the expander because the power comes. There is a power. Ini kereta polis kah?
Tak pasti.
Okay, kita ikut sama dia. We have to go left or go straight?
Go straight.
Okay, tak polis lah. Okay, let's try, let's step on it. Okay, MPV. For MPV, not bad lah. The performance and the power, Dari segi power, dari segi handling, dari segi keselesaan, dia lebih selesa daripada expander. Walaupun expander ada suspensi evolution, tapi oleh kerana dia ada door visor ni, dia punya angin lah. Angin dia datang 70 lebih, angin sudah sampai. So expander lebih senyap dari segi itu, tapi kena ingat yang ini ada door visor. So anda kalau tak boleh tahan bunyi angin, pergi test drive kereta yang tak ada door visor. Door visor adalah accessory optional. So the door visor is an optional accessory. If you don't like wind sound, please go and test and make sure that the wind sound is definitely much lesser than the expander. Okay, let's take a look at the infotainment. Ini adalah infotainment. Resolution is okay lah. not that great lah. Don't expect a Honda City or Honda Honda Civic or Honda Accord type of what they call it resolution. Let's try the music. Kenapa? Sound system is okay lah. Sound system dia boleh lah untuk family car boleh lah. Eh, jangan expect macam BMW ke apa ke. Boleh lah, cukup pakai. Enough lah, is enough. In terms of resolution, just to note, BRV comes in two variant. Eh, ada dua variant, satu E, satu V. Eh, so E tak ada reverse camera, tak ada leather seat. Eh. So the V will come with leather seats and a reverse camera. Okay, what else? E and V about the same lah. That's all.
Yeah, this one. Okay. And also the fog lamp lah.
Okay, variant yang lebih murah tak ada fog lamp also. Eh? The cheaper variant doesn't have a fog lamp also. In terms of finishing, is about the expander standard lah. All plastic, plastic, plastic. But the pickup is much better than the expander. Eh? Pickup dia lebih bagus. Bunyi engine pun lebih halus daripada expander. Eh? The engine sound is finer than the expander. It's not so rough. Okay, another corner. I think this car is more enjoyable to drive than the expander. It takes corner very, very sharply. Very good handling.
Also, this one got a pedal shift.
Okay, ini ada pedal shifter eh. Saya dah lupa semalam expander ada pedal shift ke tidak. Mungkin tidak lah. Okay, this one ada pedal shift. The cheaper model don't have lah.
Yeah, don't have.
Okay, variant yang lebih murah tak ada pedal shift eh. The cheaper variant do not have pedal shifts. Let's look at the aircon knobs. Aircon knobs are quite well done. Okay, butang-butang dia, tombol-tombol dia bagus.
Kita simpan dua pakai just go in.
Ah, boleh eh?
Ya, boleh.
Okey, jangan tunjuklah, tunjuk sinilah. Okey, Honda City mesti sudah lupa lah. Honda City sudah lupa. Dia punya tombol sini lebih cantik daripada Honda City yang sekarang ni. Eh. Honda City yang baru punya tombol variant yang bawah lah. Dia punya tombol teruk lah. Ini lebih cantik. I think Honda has forgotten that they have managed to make such a nice buttons down here last time. And the new designer for Honda City forgotten. Very nice what? Okay. Sorry.
It's an on-off aircon.
Oh, on-off.
Yeah. Oh, this. It's a wing. Yeah.
Okay. But these buttons are much better than the new Honda City, the low spec one lah. Designer forgot lah. You should just put this nicer. Okay, reverse camera dia cukup pakai lah. The resolution on the reverse camera is enough. It's not great. It's not your X50 level. It's not your what do you call it? Honda City level. I think the resolution for Honda City is much better. Otherwise, kereta ada apa? Ah, thank you very much.
Yeah, I'm sure.
So dia datang dengan analog meter. Meter analog. It comes with analog meter, and then on the right you have one digital vehicle information. Then it comes with a power outlet. Ada power outlet kat sini. Okay, power outlet. Ada tempat letak barang. Bagus. Honda is champion in cubby spaces. Eh. So it has very, very good. Very, very good cubby spaces. And it has very nice leather seats. Eh. Very nice leather seats. Okay, let's look at this. Kita tengok eh. Okay, ini kelas semua sama lah. Tapi dia punya ni solid. This is very solid. This is very nice here. Okay, even though it's black on black on black, but this is grey. Eh? This is grey. Okay, ini adalah pemandangan cockpit anda. This is your cockpit view. Very, very nice. compared to the Xpander, boleh lawan eh, boleh lawan, still can fight the Xpander. So this is your steering, ini adalah steering anda. Steering Honda Civic yang lama eh, this is the old Honda Civic steering eh. And then itu pintu, can you see the door? Comes with red leather if you buy the V spec. If you buy the lower spec, don't have. Comes with fabric seat only. So that's all. This is a test drive and also walk around because they don't have a car in the showroom. Yeah, they don't have a car in the showroom. So your engine start-stop button is here. Very nice in red. So kereta ni cantik. Dari segi pemanduan handling dia menang. Dia menang. Dia menang Xpander. Eh. Banyak yang nak tahu dia lebih bagus atau lebih teruk daripada Xpander. Dari segi handling comfort dia lebih bagus. Hanya dari segi cabin sound eh, bunyi dalam cabin mungkin dia kalah sikit, tapi tak banyak. So kalau dari segi apa yang penting pada saya lah, handling dengan keselesaan lebih penting. The light is halogen or halogen eh? Okay, lampu dia halogen eh. Even this one is halogen lah. Nampak macam LED eh.
Halogen
eh. Oh. Okay, ni ada DRL eh. Dia ada DRL berbanding dengan Xpander kalah lah. Xpander loses because the DRL is in white eh. Look at the DRL. Ha. Can you see? So nice. So the halogen lamps. Lampu kuning juga. Lampu kuning juga. Tapi samalah, sama dengan Xpander lah. Xpander ada LED LED putih. So it loses in terms of headlights because this is still using the yellow halogen headlights. Xpander is using the white LED headlights. Wait for my Xpander video, will be out on Saturday. Okay, those of you who got a look, then you are lucky lah. Okay, so ini adalah kereta BRV, walk around dan test drive sekali, dua-dua sekali. Apa lagi? Yeah, dari segi keselesaan, ride, handling and comfort, BRV menang lah. So for those of you who have been asking whether is the Xpander or the BRV, BRV wins in terms of ride, handling and comfort, in terms of engine power, in terms of pickup, BRV wins. Okay, the only thing the Xpander wins is, Xpander is a newer car, Xpander is a more sportier design. Otherwise, the BRV is a more practical car lah. Okay, dari segi apa ni, BRV dengan Xpander, BRV menang dari segi ride, handling and comfort. Okay, dari segi penampilan, Xpander menang lah. Dia kereta lebih baru, dia lebih modern. Okay, daripada itu, you boleh tengok yang lain-lain sendirilah. Eh, sama ada you suka rekaan atau tidak. See what is important to you, whether the design or the ride, handling and comfort. If ride, handling and comfort, you buy the BRV. If you like the design, Xpander, then okay, get the Xpander. Okay, prices are about the same. How much is it? Okay, harga eh. Okay, BRV ada dua spek eh. There's two spec of BRV, the E and V. The E one is 86,700 and the one with the V spec is 93. So yang V comes with leather seat, comes with the pedal shifter, fog lamp,
reverse
camera. So the lower spec doesn't have reverse camera, no leather seat, fabric seat, and then no fog lamp, no pedal shift. Okay, so prices is about the same. Take the higher one because the higher one is only 93 and then the Xpander is also 94,000. So just take the higher one. Okay guys, sampai kita jumpa lagi di video yang akan datang. Jangan lupa like, share dan subscribe. Until I see you again guys, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Bye bye.
Okay, bahasa Malaysia boleh ya?
Anything. Apa-apa bahasa pun boleh.
So second seat dia actually dia boleh ubahkan. Dia boleh depan, boleh belakang. So dalam ini harga MPV ya, macam ni ya. Dia jarang ada boleh macam ni adjust. Lagi dia boleh adjust macam ni, so boleh naik kereta sangat senang.
Okay guys, look at this. The ingress and egress is also like the Xpander. It goes up, it folds up ya. So very easy, sangat senang nak masuk. And duduk di belakang, kita cuba. Saya cuba. Okay. Ini adalah duduk di belakang. Okey, kalau lawan dengan expander dia mungkin kecil sikit lah.
Maybe okay. Itu belum adjust tepat sikit.
Okey.
You can try lah.
Okey. Kita nak cuba ni. Alamak. Nasib baik boleh. Ngam-ngam lah. Ngam-ngam. You can see you can still adjust the seat to the front. Right? But
short distance okay.
This seat is much shorter than the expander. Tempat duduk ni lebih pendek daripada yang expander punya. Okey, tapi untuk budak-budak boleh lah. Untuk orang tua susah sikit. Okey. So, belakang dia ada tempat letak barang. The back there are places to put your stuff. There's a speaker here. What else is at the back? Okay, there is no charging port. So, expander ada satu power socket di sini. So, expander ada satu power socket di sini. Tengok leather seat dia cantik eh. The leather seat is very nice. Black and red. Merah dan hitam. Leather seat dia cantik. So, kita keluar. Macam mana nak keluar? Macam ni eh. Boleh.
Sorry, saya...
Okay. Alright. So, confirm the back seat is for budak-budak lah. Orang tua macam kita tak boleh masuk. Kaki sakit, tulang sakit.